Hi, boys and girls, and welcome to Missy Lane's Book Nook. Here we are in a brand new year already. It is 2017, and I have the perfect book that I want to share with you today. It's called Happy All Year Round. It is written by Keith Baker, and I love the illustrations in this book. You'll notice that there's lots of little peas on every single page, so pay close attention to those little green vegetables. Happy All Year. So here's the month that we're in now. It says January. Happy January. Let's get going. Grab your mittens. Hooray, it's snowing. And look at the little peas on the page. What are they doing? A lot of them are skiing or sledding in the snow. Do you see these little peas over here building a snowman? And they have their mittens on and they have their hat. Happy February. Deliver Valentine's. Count to 28 or leap to 29, because there's always 28 or 29 days in February. It depends on what year it is. So on this page, the peas are getting ready for Valentine's Day, and they're making valentines or they're picking flowers for their sweetheart. Happy March. Wear a touch of green and look for leprechauns on day 17. Why would you look for leprechauns on March 17th? What does that mean? Oh yeah, it's St. Patrick's Day. Very good. You're so smart. Happy April. Walk through squishy mud. Splash in every puddle. Behold, a flower bud. Because in April, it's the start of springtime. So we get a lot of rain and there'll be mud on the ground. And it's also the time where flowers begin to grow. So you'll notice on this page, lots of the peas are holding umbrellas to keep dry. Happy May. Grease up the rusty bike. Oh, two flat tires. Who wants to take a hike? Their bike broke down. They got two flat tires, so they couldn't ride it anymore. They had a hike home. They had to take a walk. Looks like they're going up the hill. Happy June. Pack up. School's over. Clean out your messy desk. Roll in summer clover. This is one of my favorite times of the year. June, the start of summer. Lots of sunshine. Happy July. Chase the fireflies. Roll out a sleeping bag. Watch the sparkling skies. Do you like to camp out, boys and girls? Have you ever done that? Gone camping or maybe even camped out in your own backyard? Yeah, that's a lot of fun to do. And it's a good summertime activity. Happy August. Bait a fishing hook. Nap in cool shade. Reread your favorite book. I wonder what book this little pea's reading. I wonder if he checked it out of the library. Happy September. Grab paper and pen. Greet your eager teachers. School begins again. See all the peas in the window? They're in their classrooms getting ready for school to start. Happy October. Carve a toothy smile. Rake up all the leaves. Jump in every pile. And this is my other favorite time of the year. I love the month of October when we're getting ready for Halloween and the holidays are coming up and the leaves start to change color. Such a pretty time of the year. Happy November. Open the sidewalk gate. Welcome all your guests. Fill up every plate. They're getting ready to greet their friends. It looks like all their pea friends are coming over for a great big feast. What holiday would they be celebrating if friends and family are coming over for dinner? Don't forget, it's in the month of November. What holiday is that? Thanksgiving, you're right. Happy December. Tie a shiny bow. Light a glowing candle. Drink some hot cocoa. Now gather all around, pull each other near. Together we will have another happy year. So they went through all the months of the year and the different celebrations, didn't they? And this is a fun page to look at too. Look at the peas in the school bus, peas driving the cars. I thought that was a good book to start off this new year, 2017. And I want to show you something fun, boys and girls, that's fun to do perhaps after you read that book. You know you can make your own pea pictures. All you need is a green stamp pad, and if you don't have one at home, you can find these at the dollar store. And then you need your five little fingers. And your fingers are smaller than mine, so yours will definitely look like peas. But I'm going to show you how you can take a green stamp pad, and you can use all of your fingers or just one of your fingers, dip it onto your stamp pad, and then press it onto your paper. And you have a little pea. But let's do lots of peas, like lots of pea characters, just like in the book. And then you can decide what you want your peas to be doing. You can dress your peas in different costumes. You can make a pea family with a mommy pea, a daddy pea, and a baby pea. Whatever you want to do, you can fill up your whole paper. And then all you need is some crayons or some markers. I have a black marker here. So maybe I'm going to add some legs to my pea and a face, of course. And I'm going to put a baseball cap on this one. He's looking forward to baseball season. And over here, we'll give this guy arms and legs, and maybe this one has curly hair like me. And you see how you can make your pea characters? That's a lot of fun to do. And don't forget to be happy all year round. I want to teach you a rhyme, boys and girls, and you need to put up your five fingers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Put them all up. We're going to pretend that these are five fat peas. Five fat peas in a pea pod pressed. One grew, two grew, so did all the rest. They grew and they grew and they did not stop. They grew and they grew until that pea pod popped. Will you do that with me again? Put your five fingers up. Five fat peas in a pea pod pressed. One grew, two grew, so did all the rest. They grew and they grew and they did not stop. They grew and they grew until that pea pod popped. Good job. Are you ready to read another pea story? This one has a funky beat. I think you'll like it. It's called Pickin' Peas. And it's about a little girl and her pea garden, right? She's growing lots of vegetables, but specifically she's growing peas. And then there's this pesky little rabbit that likes to follow her into her garden. And do you know what that rabbit does? He eats all her peas. It's called Pickin' Peas by Margaret Reed McDonald. Little girl planted a garden of peas. Come July, those peas got ripe and ready to eat. Little girl went out in her garden and she started going down the row, picking peas, singing, "Pickin' peas, put 'em in my pail. Pickin' peas, put 'em in my pail." Just picking off the biggest ones, left the little bitty ones to grow some more. Now, boys and girls, you can help me with that. Whenever we sing that line in the story, you sing it with me at home, okay? Well, a pesky rabbit lived down in the holler. He jumped in the row behind her, started hopping along, eating her peas, and he was singing, "Pickin' peas, land on my knees. Pickin' peas, land on my knees." Can you try that at home with me? Let's be the rabbit. He was picking peas and landed on his knees. Slap your knees. Pickin' peas, land on my knees. Good job. Every time he'd sing, he'd give a jump and he'd land on his knees every time. He came down that row eating up all the peas that she left behind. Mr. Rabbit was moving along just one row behind little girl. When she'd turn the corner at the east end of the garden and start down a row, he'd turn the corner at the west end of the garden and start up a row. And she was singing, "Pickin' peas, put 'em in my pail." And the rabbit was singing, "Pickin' peas, land on my knees." After a while, little girl got to feeling like somebody was following her. She said to herself, "I think I'll cut my song right off short and see what I hear. Pickin' peas, put 'em in my..." She listened and she heard, "Land on my knees." Little girl said, "Aha, I do believe that pesky rabbit is in my garden. I do believe he's following me. I do believe he's picking my peas. She's not too happy. I think she's seen this rabbit before. She knows his tricks. She knows what he's up to. She thought a minute. I do believe if I turn back around the end of this row, I can catch him. So little girl started tiptoeing back up the row that she already picked. And there was Mr. Rabbit hopping along down at the end of the row. Picking peas, land on my knees. She crept up behind him real quiet. Picking peas, land on my knees. She reached out. Picking peas, land on my... Whoa! She caught him. She said, Mr. Rabbit, what's that you were singing about just now? Mr. Rabbit scrunched up and said, ooh, I was singing, digging up roots, land on my foot. That's not what you were singing. She squeezed him harder. What were you singing? Ooh, he said in a little squinchy voice, I was singing... Picking peas, land on my knees. That's what I thought you were singing, said little girl. You were eating up all my peas, weren't you? Maybe. Well, you won't pick my peas anymore, because I'm going to take you home, put you in a box, and keep you there till pea picking season is over. Uh-oh. So she caught the pesky little rabbit. She's going to take him home and put him in a box. Let's see what happens next. She took that rabbit home and she put him in a box and she shut the lid down real tight. She cooked a mess of peas and then she ate them all up. Well, that was good. And that little girl heard Mr. Rabbit hopping around inside that box. He was singing, picking peas, land on my knees. Mr. Rabbit, what's that you're doing in there? Trying to dance, but it's too crowded in here. Take me out and put me on top of the box. I'll dance and entertain you. What would you do if you were the little girl? Would you let the rabbit out? He just wants to dance. What is she going to decide to do? Let's turn the page and find out. Let me see that, she said. And she took him out and put him on top of the box. And he began to dance and sing. Picking peas, land on my knees. Heard my mama calling right over there. And every time he sang right over there, he took a little jump to the right. That's good dancing, said little girl. Put me on the big chest by the window and I could dance even better, said Mr. Rabbit. Uh-oh, boys and girls, I know how smart you are. Do you think this rabbit is up to something? He keeps jumping over closer to the window. And now he said, take me off the box and put me over on the chest. And she's going to do it. And what do you think he's going to do? What is he thinking? Pesky little rabbit has a plan. Little girl put him up on the big chest by the window. And Mr. Rabbit started really cutting it up. Picking peas, land on my knees. Heard my mama calling right over there. Little girl was clapping and laughing. I love your dancing, Mr. Rabbit. Put me up on that windowsill and I could really dance, said Mr. Rabbit. So little girl picked him up, set him down on that broad windowsill by the open window. Mr. Rabbit was jumping up and down and kicking his heels, picking peas, land on my knees. And when he got to the end, he gave one tremendous leap. Heard my mama calling right over there. And out the window he went. He escaped. He tricked the little girl, didn't he? By letting him out of the box, he was able to escape and go back home. Mr. Rabbit ran off through the garden singing, pick your peas and I landed on my knees. Gonna eat all I want because you can't catch me. And he got away. And I think he's pretty fast. He was a pesky little rabbit, but he was a smart little rabbit, too. I'd like to say that that's the last the girl saw of that rabbit, but I'm afraid he was right back there the next morning, picking peas and landing on his, what, boys and girls? his knees. You got it. Picking peas, land on my knees. The end. What did you think of that story, boys and girls? That was an old trickster tale. It actually originated in Africa, and it was retold by this author. I'm going to teach you another poem or another rhyme. And this one, too, just like our story, had a special kind of beat. This rhyme has a beat, so I need your help again. I want you to keep the beat for me by slapping your lap and clapping your hands. We're going to slap, clap, slap, clap. Will you do that with me? Good. Keep that beat. Peas, porridge, hot. Peas, porridge, cold. Peas, porridge in the pot, 9 days old. Some like it hot, some like it cold. Some like it in the pot, 9 days old. Good job. All right, boys and girls, I have one more short story that I would like to share with you today. And it's called Too Many Tomatoes. So we read some stories about peas. And those are really good for you and so delicious. Some kids don't always like to try a new vegetable and they shy away from peas, but it's always a good idea to taste your vegetables because you never know if you'll like it or not until you taste it. And peas are yummy. But in this book, there's a garden full of vegetables, not only peas, but carrots and onions and potatoes and tomatoes. In fact, there's too many tomatoes. Grandfather's garden is popping with peas. It's buzzing with blossoms and bumblebees. It's bursting with berries and beans and potatoes and tall twining vines of too many tomatoes. Look at all the tomatoes. What are they going to do with that many? Too many tomatoes, too many to see. Too many for Grandpa and Grandma and me. A plateful, a crateful, a grateful, hooray. This town has too many tomatoes today. So you can make a lot of things out of tomatoes. And it's also very nice to share your tomatoes. And it looks like that's what they're doing here. They're sharing with their neighbors. They're giving some of their tomatoes away. Grandpa began with a handful of seeds and sun, soil, and water, as every seed needs. One sprout and another, a shout of surprise. Too many tomatoes climb up to the skies. See the vines getting taller and taller. Bursting from barrels and buckets and pails, over the rooftop and over the rails. A holler, a dollar, a nickel, a penny. Sing me a song of tomatoes too many. Look at all the bushels full. And they still have more growing in their garden. Down to the sidewalk and down to the street, drippy and slippery, juicy and sweet. Red ones and yellow ones, shiny and round, jumbling, tumbling over the ground. Look, a couple toppled out of his basket and splat, there they go on the sidewalk. That's okay, they have so many more. Tomatoes on trains, tomatoes on tracks, tomatoes on tow trucks with cars on their backs. Tomatoes that topple from towering vines, crawling and sprawling in curling designs. Now they're loading up the tomatoes on trucks and even on trains. And where are they taking the tomatoes? Where are those tomatoes going? What does that say, boys and girls? Do you know? Farmers market, Saturdays. Too many tomatoes, too many to find, too many above, too many behind. You can take your produce, the things that you grow from your garden, whether it be fruits or vegetables, and you can sell them at a farmer's market. A farmer's market is like a grocery store outside. So there's stands of different things that you can walk to and buy. They're going to have a tomato stand, and they're going to sell their tomatoes. A biscuit to butter, a basket to borrow. Sing me a song of tomatoes tomorrow. One for the teacher and one for the tailor. One for the scientist and one for the sailor. One for the painter, and one for the plumber. One for the dancer, and one for the drummer. His drum says tomato attack. I like that. One for the man at the magazine stand, and one for the girl with a book in her hand. One for the boy sleeping under the tree, one for my neighbor, and one just for me. Of course he had to save one for himself. That was a good idea. Tomatoes, just like peas, are oh so delicious and oh so good for us. And like I said, there's lots of things that you can make from tomatoes. You can make tomato sauce to put over your spaghetti. Ketchup is made from tomatoes. You can put your ketchup on your hamburger and your french fries. You can put tomatoes in soup. You can put a lot of vegetables in soup. And actually, that gives me another song idea. Can you put out your arms like this, boys and girls? Make it nice and round, like it's a big kettle, a soup pot. And we're gonna pretend that we're making a big pot of soup today. Okay? The soup is boiling up. The soup is boiling up. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. First we put in some peas. First we put in some peas. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. The soup is boiling up. The soup is boiling up. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. Next we add some tomatoes. Next we add some tomatoes. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. Peas and tomatoes are already in there. What else could we add to our soup? What vegetable do you like to eat at home? Carrots is a good idea. The soup is boiling up. The soup is boiling up. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. Now let's add some carrots. Now let's add some carrots. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. Can you smell it? Starting to smell so delicious. What should we put in next? Potatoes. Great idea. The soup is boiling up. The soup is boiling up. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. Next we'll add some onions. Next we'll add some onions. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. Let's add some onion. The soup is boiling up. The soup is boiling up. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. Next we'll add some onions. Next we'll add some onions. Stir slow, around we go. The soup is boiling up. You could keep on adding as many vegetables as you'd like, but it smells so good already. Let's grab our spoons and take a taste. You ready? Delicious. Great job, everybody. Well, boys and girls, thanks for joining me on today's Book Nook. I had so much fun reading to you about delicious vegetables, especially peas. And before we end today's show, I want to introduce you to a special friend. I actually have a friend who is a pea. His name is Elemenop, just like you sing the alphabet, L-M-N-O-P. But he's a pea character, and he has a special message for everybody. He likes to remind boys and girls everywhere to get smart, to keep reading, to keep learning, to visit your local library, to help you get smarter each and every day. And I'll see you next time, boys and girls, on Missy Lane's Book Nook. Thanks for watching.